never told me.
Okay, let Sayonpal read fast. Sayonpal, read fast. Read from here.
Sir, then after Sayonpal, I.
Okay, Sayon.
After Sayonpal, I. Okay.
Will you read or will I give it to someone else?
Okay, sir, I am reading.
Okay, start reading.
Sir, after him, I.
Omnivore.
Omnivore.
Yes.
We are human beings. Ducks and hens are omnivores.
Yes. What are omnivores? Bears are omnivores. Have you seen bear? This one is a bear.
No, I saw in one zoo.
Yes. Have you seen crow? What does the crow do?
Crow is an available thing.
Yes. So, okay. Tell me, Sayonpal, have you seen human beings?
Yes.
Have all of you seen human beings? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So we have seen ducks. We have seen hens. This is a duck. This is a hen. So bears, crows, human beings, ducks, and hens are omnivores. What are omnivores? Omnivores are those animals which eat both plant and animals. Is that clear? They eat both plant and animals. Is that clear? Okay. Now read from here, Sayon.
Birds have beaks and claws adapted to their food type.
Yes.
Some birds catch the eat small
catch and
animals.
Eat small animals.
Sir, that is eat.
That is eat. This one is eat. Okay. This one is eat.
Oh, well, you are using lifespan.
Yes. Now.
They are called birds of prey.
Yes.
They have sharp and strong claws to capture their prey.
Yes.
They use their hooked beaks to tear the flesh.
Yes.
Eagle, kite, vulture, etc. are birds of prey.
Okay, so let us understand the birds of prey. Okay. Now these birds have beak. What are beak? These are beak. You know? These are beak of a bird. What are these? These are beak. Yes, these are beak. And claws. Have you seen claws? See, these are claws. But birds have beaks and claws adapted to their food type. Now, see, these claws are small. These claws are small. If you see the claw of an eagle, it will be like this. Okay.
Yes, because we can eat the flesh of animals.
Yes, let me show you. Let me show you the claw of an eagle. Okay. Let me show you the claw of an eagle. Just wait for some time. This is the claw of an eagle. See, this
very
is
sharp.
Yes, let me show you the claw of an eagle. Can you see this one? OMG.
Yes.
Can you see this one? So big. Can you see this one?
Yes.
See, this is the claw of an eagle. How is it? This is so big, right? This is the claw of an eagle.
Can kill a human being also.
Human being doesn't have a claw this big. See? Can you see the size of the claw? Can you see the size of the claw? It's so big. How can human being have a so big claw like that?
No. That. Sir?
Yes. See, can you see the size of the claw?
Sir, please show the difference between that human being claw and the eagle's claw.
See, eagle's claw is so big and so hooked. Can you see this one? It is so big and hooked. And yes. Now, if you see the claw of a sparrow,
it is small.
It is small in size. See? Let us see the claw of a sparrow. See, this is the claw of a sparrow. Yes, this is the claw of a sparrow. Is it small or big? Very much small. Will it be able to harm? Will it be able to harm anyone?
Rat also.
Yes. Will
very little big of our nail.
Yes. First, tell me, will this claw be able to harm someone?
No.
Will this small claw be able to harm someone?
It can harm, but not very much.
Yes, okay. So we have understood about claw. And this in similarly we can see that they have their beaks and claws adapted to their food type. Now see the beak, can you see this beak? This beak is like this, right? Do you see this beak?
Are you not very much good?
Yes, this beak, the beak of the eagle is like this. Which one is sharp? Which one is sharp? Is this sharp or is this one sharp? Which one is sharp?
Eagles.
Yes, it is sharp and hooked.
Eagle.
Yes, it is sharp and hooked. See, it is sharp and it is hooked. Is that clear? The beak is sharp and hooked. Okay, now, adapted to their food type. Some birds catch and eat small animals. They are called birds of prey. So, is hen a bird of prey or is eagle a bird of prey?
Eagle.
Some birds catch and eat small animals. They are called birds of prey. So every animal is not bird of prey. Only those who catch and eat small animals are birds of prey. Is this clear?
Yes.
Okay. Is this clear to all of you? Okay. Now. Yes. Now. Now, they have sharp and strong claws to capture their prey. They have sharp and strong claws, okay? The claws will be sharp and strong. They use their hooked beak.
They can capture prey of some animal.
Yes. They use their hooked beaks to tear the flesh. Eagle, kite, vulture, etc. are birds of prey. See, we need to learn these points. You will be asked about some examples. Those will be eagle, kite and vulture. Is that clear? Okay.
Yes.
Now, this time, I will ask Soma Roy Biswas. Who is Soma Roy Biswas?
Here.
Yeah. Okay. Here, start reading from birds. Some birds like sparrows. Tushar, rotate your camera. Tushar, rotate your camera. You will be able to see better. Here also, rotate your camera. You will be able to see better. Now, here start reading. Rotate your camera. Turn on the auto-rotate option. Turn on the auto-rotate
sir,
option also.
I am
also
reading with my book.
Yeah, you can read with your book. That's also okay. Start reading.
Okay, starting. Our camera.
Yeah, start reading. We are 16 of us are doing this class. 16 of us are doing this class. It's a very good thing for all of us. See, 16 of us are doing this class. That's very good of all of you.
15.
Okay, now. Now,
some birds
birds
have short and strong beaks.
Yes, so some birds, wait, some birds like sparrows. We have just seen sparrow. How is the beak of a sparrow? So, beak of a sparrow will be small like the hens. Is that clear? Okay. But some birds like sparrow have short and strong beaks. Okay, now read from there here. Read from
and
there.
They use their beaks to crush grains and seeds.
Yes.
Insects have various types of mouth parts.
Yes.
Mosquitoes and bugs have piercing mouth organs to suck blood.
Yes.
Cockroaches and grasshoppers have strong biting
and chewing
mouth parts.
Okay, wait. Okay, now they use, all of you turn off your mic, they use their beaks to crush grains. What does the sparrow eat? Does sparrow eat chicken? Does sparrow eat rat? Does sparrow eat snake? No, sparrow eats small grains. Is that clear?
Grains.
Okay. Can all of you see me beside, can all of you see me beside the board?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So they use their beaks to crush grains and seeds. So their beaks must be hard. Can you crush rice with your teeth? Can you do that?
Yes.
Is rice hard or tough?
Yes.
Is rice hard or tough? Is rice hard or is rice soft? Which one is rice hard or soft? hard. So if a sparrow has to bite that, the sparrow's beak has to be strong. Is that clear? So that it can crush the grains and the seeds. Okay, now insects have various type of mouth parts. Mosquitoes and bugs have piercing mouth part. Have anyone got bitten by a mosquito?
Have many times.
Yes.
Does it pain when the mosquito bites? Does it pain when the mosquito bites?
Yes.
So what does the mosquito do? Yes. Yes.
In our body and suck the blood.
Yes. How we will see how mosquitoes suck blood. Okay, wait. Do you see this image? Can you see this image here at the side? Is the mosquito having a piercing part?
Yes.
Can you see that the mosquito is having a piercing part? Okay. Now, if we see a video, yes? Yes.
What is the taste of our blood? How is the taste of our blood that the mosquito likes us?
I cannot understand which is true. Ask the question.
Now
all of you.
Our blood will be very sweet.
See, all of you don't speak together. Okay. Oitijo. Only Oitijo. Oitijo, what is your question?
I am telling that how is the taste of our blood that the mosquitoes like it very much?
Our blood is actually alcoholic in nature. Alcoholic in nature means if you taste blood, it will taste like thickness. It will taste thick. What is thick? If you taste chun or if you taste calcium, if you taste magnesium hydroxide, it will taste thick. Thick means it will give a thick feeling to our tongue. Is that clear? Okay, now let us see this. Is it piercing the needle? Is it piercing the needle? Is it piercing the needle?
Yes.
Yes. See, it is sucking the blood. Can you see this is the egg of a mosquito? This is the larva of a mosquito. Do you see this?
Yes.
Okay.
I saw this in the light.
See, it is penetrating. Can you see that it is penetrating? This is known as proboscis, the tube-like structure which is getting inserted into our skin. This is proboscis. Can you see that it is sucking blood?
Yes.
Can you see? See, this is the needle-like structure which is taken out. Can you see the needle-like structure?
Yes.
See, it is inserting the needle-like structure. Can you see that?
Yes.
Yes, and see, it is sucking the blood.
Wow.
See, it is its proboscis entering and searching for a blood vessel. Can you see that?
Sir, how they do this type of picture?
How they? I don't know that. I don't know, but see, they have taken the picture. See, the proboscis is entering our capillaries. See, it is sucking blood from the capillary. Can you see that?
Yes. Sir,
yes.
I think that is one animation.
No, it is not animation. It's a real life thing. It's not an animation.
Yes.
It's not animation.
By eating the blood, the mosquitoes become very fat.
Yes.
Yes.
After sucking the blood, it will become very fat. Yes, it will become very fat. Okay. So we have understood. Okay. We have understood how a mosquito sucks our blood. Okay. We have understood how a mosquito sucks our blood. Now. Yeah, tell
how
me.
How flies heavy?
Ha.
Sir, like
how
this.
Heavy.
Yes, okay. So after that, to suck blood, cockroaches and grasshoppers have strong biting and chewing mouth part. Okay. Cockroaches and grasshoppers. Yes, they have strong biting and chewing mouth parts. Okay, that means they can chew and bite in a better way using such mouth parts. Is that okay?
Okay.
Now, read from
sir,
house flies.
See me one video. Sir, see me one video.
See me. Sir, show me.
Show me. Cockroach.
Okay. I will show that video later on. Let me complete this page. Okay. Now.
Sir,
I will give the link of that video. Okay, now house flies have a
spongy bed like tongue.
Butterflies have a long thin tube attached to their mouth. And silent Bali, you please quiet your mouth.
And very good rhyming teacher.
And teacher, you please take me a cow. Sir, give me a cow.
And we will be home with that in full Sandipur.
Wow, 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 milk, 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 milk.
You can give the picture of your account in Cobra Bandi.
Yes, no break a Cobra Bandi.
And what happened? Hello?
Okay. Well, do you hear me now? Yeah, I bought the battery.
Yes,
okay. Do you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, now, so house flies have a spongy pad-like tongue. Butterflies have a long, thin tube attached to their mouth. It is called proboscis. What is it called? It is called proboscis. Okay, now, they use it to suck nectar from flowers. Why do they use proboscis? So that they can suck nectar. Yes, so that they can suck nectar from flowers. Is that clear? Okay. Now,
yes.
Breathing method is animal. Who will read? Oitijo. No, where is Oitijo?
Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. I'm here in my home.
Huh?
I am in my home.
You say yes sir, I am in my home.
Okay, read from all living things.
All living things. Okay,
yes.
Breathing methods in animals. All
yes.
Living things need to breathe air to stay alive.
Yes.
They take in oxygen from the air.
Yes.
Different animals have different organs to breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide.
Yes. So, first thing is that living things need to breathe air to alive. We cannot stay alive without having some air inside of our body. We need to breathe air continuously. We need to take oxygen. Animals need to take oxygen from the air. Okay, now, different animals have different organs to breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon. We breathe in oxygen and we breathe out carbon dioxide. So, different animals need to breathe in oxygen and carbon dioxide. They need to breathe out carbon dioxide in different various methods. Okay, now first one, read fast.
Birds, reptiles and mammals breathe through their lungs. The
yes.
Air is taken through the nostrils.
Yes.
It reaches the lungs through the windpipe.
Yes.
The lungs take in oxygen that is passed into the blood to be utilized
by the body.
Okay,
now let us study this one. Birds, reptiles and mammals breathe through their lungs. We have lungs. When we breathe, our lungs get elongated. Okay, when we breathe, our lungs expand. Our lungs expand. That is, when we breathe, our lungs expand. So, we breathe through our lungs. Okay, the air is taken in through the nostrils. We take the air in through this nostril. Okay, and it, yes.
What is the picture in the interesting fact? Whose picture is there?
I cannot understand.
Lung.
Tell me again.
In the interesting fact. In the interesting fact, who is not lungs?
Shayon, I will be Shayon. When someone is speaking, you need to stop, otherwise I'll remove you. Mute you. Yes, tell me Utijo.
In the interesting fact there is the lung picture.
Interesting
fact.
What are you telling? Industrial plant. I cannot.
Interesting fact.
I cannot understand. Tell me the spelling.
That yellow box at the side, oxygen passes into the blood.
Oh, interesting fact.
He's telling that
oxygen passes into the blood through the lung walls when we breathe in. Yes.
He's telling that is the picture of lung. He's telling that
maybe
is the picture
I cannot,
of lung for another.
Maybe I cannot see it from here. I cannot understand the picture from here. Okay, maybe it is the picture of lungs. I have to see the book again. Okay, now let us continue our study. So the air is taken in through the nostrils. It reaches the lungs through the windpipe. What is the windpipe? This one is the windpipe. Okay, and this one is nostril. We have nostril. Humans have two nostrils. Okay. Now, it reaches the lungs through the windpipe. The lungs take in oxygen that is passed into the blood to be utilized by the body. The lungs take in oxygen that is passed into the blood to be utilized by the body. So, if this is a lung, there will be capillaries outside of the lung. Okay. Now, carbon dioxide from these capillaries will go into the lung. Oxygen from these capillaries will go into the lung, and carbon dioxide from the lung, I'm telling the wrong thing. Carbon dioxide from the capillaries will go into the lung, and oxygen from the lung will go into the capillaries. Okay, remember, lungs to capillary or blood vessel, there will be transfer of oxygen. Capillary
means,
sir, why you have written 20 lungs?
O2 means oxygen.
No, they are at first 20 lungs to capillary.
20 is the page number.
That
okay,
is
capillary
page number.
Capillary to lungs.
That I'm thinking.
Capillary to lungs, there will be transfer of CO2. Okay, remember, from lungs to capillary, there will be transfer of oxygen. From capillary to lungs, there will be transfer of CO2. Is that clear to all of you? Is that clear to all of you? Okay, very good. So it is 9:50 now. So we need to finish our class. Have all of you understood what we have taught you?
Yes.
Okay. So.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So our class will be over for today. Bye, bye, all of you.
Bye, bye, sir.
Bye, bye.